Hey there, fellas. So this is going to be my first video that is not going to be uploaded to YouTube. It's just for you fellas here on the forum. And this one is specifically for Sebastian Schoff. He asked me to do a video on how to do weapon slings on weapons. Because that's where weapon slings would go. These things, these straps that are hanging on these things here. Now, when you buy a kit for figures, generally these things don't come with them. It's a detail that you have to add yourself. Same thing with like this wire here and maybe a couple of other little things like straps for holding on gear and webbing and stuff like that. Normally they don't come with the kit and you have to make them yourself. Now, I'm not used to doing them on modern figures, that's for sure. I've never actually done it before that I remember. Oh no, yes I have. I don't go to huge lengths worrying about the detail, because the 35th scale, it's somewhat difficult to see a lot of the detail unless you're taking pictures of them like super up close and stuff like that. If you're going to be doing that, you're going to need to go to a different level of detail, one that I don't go to. So that this video is not for that. This one is basically to perform what's called suggested detail. Detail that is implied at a distance of about 3 feet. So if you're looking at a model about 3 feet away, you'll see that there's a weapon sling hanging on the weapon, and it looks like a weapon sling at about 3 feet away. Reality, 1-to-1 scale, 3 feet, not 3 feet at 35th scale. That's what I'm referring to. So, there's a couple of different materials you can use to make weapon slings. Normally what I use is, if I can find it, this stuff right here. Get out of there. This, it's flat lead wire. I get it from UMM USA, as it says right there. It's really, really cheap, and there's a whole lot of it in there. There's enough to do 30, 40, 50, 60 weapon slings in there. I also use them for straps, for putting gear on the side of tanks and stuff like that, for stowage and all kinds of stuff. They're really handy. I have a whole bunch of them there. I buy them in like a box of, sorry about that, an assortment of stuff. So different lengths and widths and stuff like that. This is 2.2 mil by, looks like 1 mil. Can't really see it, the stuff's in the way. 0.2 mil by 1 mil, it says on there. That's the size that I usually use for weapon slings. And it's the one that makes me happy, it's the lead wire. Now, I have a piece of it already cut. Stuck in some super glue. It's extremely malleable and extremely poseable. And it's very tough too. You can fold it and tie it in knots and loop it around, and it's very realistically drapeable for like a leather or a canvas type sling. World War II slings tend to be leather, and I think the modern stuff is like a canvasy type material, or maybe even a leather, I'm not really sure. either way, you can't really see the texturing and stuff at 35th scale unless you get up really, really close. But my figures are more the suggested detail figure than anything else. I don't go to that level of detail in my figures. So if you're looking for that, you go to a different video, because you're not going to find it here. So that's what that looks like. Now, that's not the only material that you can use. Another material, if you are looking for some kind of a texture, this is cool stuff. This here is the tin foil, or the foil, I don't know if it's tin foil, from the top of a peanut butter container. I keep those. I also use the stuff from the tops of coffee cans, those big, huge coffee cans. I use that stuff as well. I like the stuff from the tops of peanut butter because it's fairly poseable and it remembers its shape. There's no spring to it, right? And it has a bit of a texture on the inside, so it makes good tarps. But it also makes good weapon slings if you're going for like 16th scale stuff. So now for this purposes, I'll use this because I'm pretty sure this is what Seb can get his hands on. I don't think he can get this, but I'll do both. Right, I'll do, because this is what I want to use on my figures, but I'll do a couple in this as well, just to show how it's done. Now, if you look, these slings are fairly elaborate in the way they look. There's a loop at the top, and then there's a join there of like a cross piece, and then there's another loop at the bottom with another cross piece that holds it like a binder. You can see it better here on this one here. So there's like two loops at either end, right? Now on this larger weapon here, there's an even, it looks like there's a padded strip in there. So you would need to add a wider strip in there in order to simulate that. I don't know which I think that's the squad assault weapon. This looks like the same thing as this, but it has some kind of grenade launcher on it. I'm not familiar enough with modern weapons to know what these are. These look like M16s to me, but they have different foregrips on them, so they may not be, I don't know. Either way, they all look deadly and very capable of performing their function. So the reason I have these figures and these figures is for my New Age Desert Rats group build entry. These Marines are going to go on my diorama to go with my the NPC, or the APC that I put on there, the Bradley from Meng. And these fellas here are just going to be some more bad dudes that I got hiding in the rubble of the town that the vehicles are traveling through. So I need to do some weapon slings for a few of the figures that I have. One that's already deployed on the diorama, and then these four here. So that's the purpose of this video. Anyway, so I'll get these built up, and then I will come back and show how I do the weapon slings. So I'll be back in a bit. Okay, so the weapon slings are really not the most complicated thing in the universe to build. I've already built one up. Let's see if I can. I have to use the super zoom on this thing in order to, because it's pretty small work. That's one of them there. It's a little wider than I normally would prefer because I use the foil from the peanut butter for it. It's a little hard to cut it, but that's generally what I go for. I got the loop in the front, there's a loop in the back, there's a little tiny strip that's holding the loop closed there, and a little strip that's holding it there, and it's, as you can see, soft and malleable, so you can shape it to whatever shape you need. So that's one of those done. I'll do another one here. This is the foil. See if I can make it a little thinner this time. Now usually I use a straight edge, but lazy. Alright, that's about how long I make them. So what's that? About 3.5 centimeters is about how long I usually make them. I don't need to make them longer than that. So I'll need a strip that long, and then I will need two small bits for the little things that hold the loops closed. I'll probably lose these and have to remake them. Alright, this is pretty fiddly business, so I'm going to use my geek goggles to do it. But my eyes aren't as good as they used to be. Okay, so first thing I do is make the first loop. About maybe 4 centimeters long. Second one about the same. Try to maintain the loop so it's if there's an opening. That way you'll be able to see it when it's on the gun. Take a bit of CA glue. And just a dab under where the loop connects to hold it down. To glue it to your cutting mat. Right. That's on there. Now if you want to be clever, hold the thing still. So it's not flopping around. I'm not usually that clever though. Now the next thing you want to do is put on the little stays. My head's not in the way. You can't see all that well. A little dab will do you there. Stay on. Leave it so it's open. Don't put a lot of CA glue on because you want it to dry in a timely fashion. You don't want to be sitting around waiting for CA glue to dry for 5 or 10 minutes. Now I always use the thick CA glue. I don't use that runny stuff ever. I've had it ruin too many models. I use the thicker, slower drying stuff. I just don't need it to dry fast. I need it to dry strong, not fast. So, all right, so that's that. It usually only takes a couple of moments for it to harden up. I flip it over. Put it back down. Drop a CA on the ends of the two bits of the stay. And then you fold them over. I don't like doing work on photo etch. I know Seb will hate that because he can't stand photo etch. Which I can understand. Photo etch is a sphincter clencher. It does have its uses. Pretty fiddly work. All right. So that's on there. Now, this is the kind of annoying bit. The shape. The sling in the general shape that you want for the gun. It doesn't have to be the exact final position. You just want to be able to attach it to the gun. Like it's attached on there. So here's the gun. And I'll take more. CA. It connects right there on the end of this buttstock. A little bit there. And it connects right here at the end of this foregrip. And I'll just push it in so it makes contact. Pretty fiddly work, like I said. Now here's the caveat. I always add this. This is the way I do it. That doesn't mean this is the only way to do it. Doesn't mean there's an easier way to do it. Doesn't mean that there's a harder way to do it. This is just my way. Doesn't mean it's right, wrong, left, center, whatever, what have you. That's it. So, that's how I do it, using the tin foil, the foil type stuff. So that's two of those done with foil. Now I got this fella here that I'm going to use this piece of lead strip to do pretty much the same thing. So now I want it to be the same length, so about 3.5 centimeters. And I'll use that little leftover bit to do the stays. Now, lead is weird stuff. Lead's really toxic. You probably don't want to be touching it like I am with my hands. You don't want to do that. Probably not a great idea. But I'm too lazy to go get my rubber gloves out. And I hate handling things with my rubber gloves because I can't stand the feeling of latex on my skin. So I'll run the risk of lead poisoning. But I don't recommend you do this with your bare skin at all. Because, like I said, lead's very poisonous. That's why in some countries it's a controlled material and you can't buy it or whatever. It's not here. I can just go buy it at my local hardware store. I can't buy it in this format. It comes in a ball. It's for fishing and stuff like that. This I have to buy from a hobby shop down in the United States. I can buy lead sheet too. Lead sheet. I have a couple pieces of lead sheet around that I use. I got them from other hobby shops and stuff too. And but yeah, handling it with your bare hands is not the wisest thing in the universe to do, but nobody ever accused me of being wise, so why break with the pattern? So for the sake of argument, just pretend I'm wearing rubber gloves. You do the exact same thing that you did with the foil. Now one of the things about lead is it reacts very unusually with CA glue. It almost welds itself to CA glue. I have no idea why, but when you attach something made of lead to CA glue, it has this weird, extremely sticky effect. It's kind of, I don't know why. I've never been able to find any information on it, or I don't know. But it, the CA glue seems to bond really, really well to lead. For example, when I go to stick this weapon sling to this gun, it will stick very easily to the plastic on the gun. Much better than the foil did. and the glue will dry very, very fast. It's like some kind of an off-gassing or something like that. It's probably highly toxic and will kill me, but I'll die happy because I'm modeling. Sad thing is that wasn't really a joke. Okay. Now, let's get clever again. Stick you down. SCA. SCA glue is starting to harden up now. Difficult to use. Close these. Now I could, for these stays, instead of using pieces of the lead like this, I could use little pieces of wire, which I'm thinking probably would be a bit better scale, but holy crap, my eyes couldn't handle that. Way too small. I'm finding as I get older, it's more and more difficult for me to handle small photo etch and delicate parts like that for long periods of time. I start to get headaches and stuff, even with the geek goggles on. I can't even do most of the modeling now without the geek goggles on. So it's pretty rough. It's kind of annoying. So, I cheat a lot. I decide that I just don't need to go to that level of detail now. So I'm expecting that when I get into my 70s and 80s, if I live so long, my models won't look anywhere near as good as they did when I was in my 40s. Because I'll be blind as a bat. Now, I've got to check the reference to see where this sling attaches above that. Okay. Freshen CA. Not very much. Attachment point, same on the back here. I think it was on the front stock there. It properly. Sit there. And like I said, the CA glue seems to affect the lead slightly differently. It's like a pressure sensitive. And when you push on it, it accelerates the bond. I don't know if that back one attached. Yeah, it seems to have. Yeah, it did. Okay. And because the lead is like super, super soft, it's extremely poseable. So that's pretty much a fast and dirty way that I do weapon slings. Like I said, very simplistic. You can go a lot more detailed than that. You can, like I said, go to the down to more detail with using wire. You can use fabric to do some of the canvas work and stuff like that if you really wanted to go crazy, but I don't go to that level. I don't get that close, and I don't take pictures of my work up that close, so I don't need to do that. So like I said, fast, easy, dirty way to do weapon slings. You can pull it off with the three foot rule. Looks like a weapon sling from 3 feet away. So, there you go. Hopefully that was of some use, Seb. I'll try and get this up as quick as I can so you can put it to use. Anyway, you guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.